around. And I mean, Tom, that's really kind of outrageous when you think about it, but it is about supply and demand. The more people that demand housing, the more the cost tends to go up. But there is something going on in the market these days, because I'm hearing more and more from individuals that are getting quote-unquote sweet deals, where they are threatening that maybe, you know, I'm going to leave your property and go to a newer, brighter, shinier property, maybe like down by National Stadium, and they in turn have been offered, well, wait, before you leave this building that's been, you know, here for 20 years, let me see how we can work out an arrangement so that your, there will not be a rent increase.
That happens a lot in commercial real estate, where people threaten new building. That's beside a direct issue to housing, the issue of jobs.
Mm-hmm.
I've been surprised no candidates that I've heard have talked about the Department of Employment Services, which is a huge bureaucracy, which is a master group. Tens of millions of dollars in federal funds. Yet we have the horrible unemployment each of them. We have unemployment around the city. And where is the Department of Employment Services? Don't we need a Michelle Reed, like, shake up of that office? We don't have to endorse Michelle Reed for that, but I mean, it's some kind of dramatic change in how we look at that office, how that money just flows to who knows where.
I tend to agree with you, Tom, if you suspect. I don't know if it's Michelle Reed, and I don't know really what that means. I mean,
she was in the state of whatever the status quo was, she changed.
Yeah, and I think we definitely have to change the status quo with that department. The new acting director is, you know, doing leapfrog over some of the issues, but I don't know if that's enough. But it is a department that we depend on to help get D.C. residents' jobs.
I can bet you there were federal reports saying they can't tell you how many people get
that's
jobs,
correct.
And they can't tell you how many people keep jobs.
That's correct. That's correct. And we need a different system of accountability in the government.
What would a successful system look like?
I think, well, Tom kind of hit it on the head. Those two questions certainly need to be answered. But in addition to that, I think we need to go into communities and encourage people to become a part of the workforce. And what I mean is, it's one thing to apply for a job, it's another to know that you have the skills. And one of the areas we get very low marks on is the training, because our training programs, one, are not certified. They should be. And they need to match.
Anita Bonds, who depends for a large council member for re-election. Our guest today is Michael Schaefer, Washingtonian editor. Thanks for being here.
Thank you, Tom.
It's been a great thing. I'm Tom Sherwood, sitting in today for Pedro Rumbi. We'll be back maybe next week or the week after. Hope he's having a good time wherever he is. Thank you for listening to us. Have a good day.
Support for WANU 88.5.